So ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Yeah, I want to read some phrase there, some passage from some magazine somewhere. I don't know who wrote it, what it was saying, and who it was meant for. But we can find out together. Okay? And it reads as follows. Two teachers from each school selected for the pilot to be trained as trainers. With the newly developed materials, they are then expected to facilitate training for and encourage other teachers via teacher group meetings and via teacher resource centers to use new approach, approaches and materials in their respective schools and zones. And I cut it, I typed it there. Could you know who perhaps this passage was referring to? You can tell. It was written in 1971. It would have been referring to who? Yeah? To? To
me.
To you, right? Yeah, it was referring to ourselves. We are we two from pilot schools? 1 month, 1 science. Are we the one that's referring to that after being trained, we shall be trained of trainers? We are the ones, eh? And that we shall facilitate and encourage other teachers through teacher group meetings. We are the ones. Be sure. How many are sure you are the ones? Ah. And we are sure that we shall also use teacher resource centers. Now that's not critical, that's not important at all. But I think what's coming next is what's more important. Which is that our encouragement will not be, no, but the encouragement is that they should use what? New approaches, isn't it? And new materials. And Dr. Nkata here just emphasized, there must be something new. You can see the word new there. But you have left people home or at school who will be telling you, ah, isn't that mom baby? Are they there?
Yes.
Or are you here?
Yes.
This is just donor money. This ministry also number donors. And also, and more dangerously so, these teacher group meetings will not work. The danger is, if you who is here, you belong to two of these aspects I've mentioned. One, if you yourself, you go out empty-handed, and you go and start bullying people in terms of meetings. So think they will be coming to your meeting. They will not. So make sure that you go with a package. Not in the flash. No, I'm not training. What a good trainer, you see the flash. No. It must be in the head. When the flash is lost, you are also lost. If you are such a one, then we are in more trouble than we can imagine. And more so, if you always come here, you have just come here by mere luck. You don't even know what happened that your name was on the list. And people at school, they say, but why have they picked that one? Who doesn't even attend the meeting? They know us, huh? Except those schools where there are only two, one head, one head, because they say, obvious. And they have threatened themselves. But there are some of us from big schools who, when there is a type of meeting, we don't attend. There's a stakeholders meeting, we don't go there. anything that is happening at school for CPD, you don't participate. And then you have come here by the miracle of Jesus to come and train as trainer of who? Are they going to respect you? So if you are here, please, when we knock off, don't even go to the bank tomorrow, just go back home. Because people will not come to your meeting. They'll be very discouraged. Even as you are here, they're very discouraged. The only good thing that we are told, you are very active facilitators and active participants, isn't it, all of you? And you merit being here. And you merit being a trainer of trainers, of teachers in your schools. So welcome aboard, ladies and gentlemen. I'm welcoming you. Are you welcome?
Yes.
I'm not threatening anyone. Am I? Of course, as I speak, I'm seeing now people dropping the wrinkles on their face, including some ladies. You don't have to drop wrinkles, just smile. So this is about you and the whole purpose of being here. And please, 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 let us go and do something different. Let us go and bring out new ways of teaching, new ways of learning, new ways of collaborating among ourselves as teachers. We have heard that we'll be using the framework of sprints to do our trainings, okay? And that the methodology for learning the content, for improving our content knowledge as teachers and our pedagogy knowledge as teachers will be through lesson starts. That's the mode we shall take. So when we simply say we'll be using sprint, or it means we are going to use the structures of sprint to do the training. So no one will be getting on here to, I'm not going to hold a workshop. Each school here is represented. So much of the training will be taking place in the school you are coming from, among us, the teachers that are in your school. So let us discuss briefly something about sprint in the educating our future. That's why our base is for sprint. We have a chapter there on CPD. You will not find the word sprint in educating our future. You'll find the word CPD. From somewhere under 110 pages, they are going to 120 pages. It talks about the CPD that we'll be doing as teachers must be based at school. That's what it says. And that it must be cost effective. And that it must respond to the needs of the teachers in that school. So that's what makes our CPD framework in Zambia very different from all the countries around. In some countries around, the framework they have contains the content teachers will be learning. It's like a syllabus, kind of. So the framework they'll have, it will have the topics teachers are supposed to be doing in their CPDs. And thank God that we still have put up one semester. Most of us have been there several times to go and do the same way we're doing it. So what they do, they'll create a framework, put content there, and you'll be doing it. And the structure there, therefore, is top down. So you have national trainers, then you have county trainers, district trainers, zone trainers, and school trainers. So there's a large structure. In that kind of framework. In Zambia here, it's different. We don't provide the content in our framework. Policy says we ourselves must identify the content based on our needs. So the need at your school, it could be different from the need at another school. And so you must desire. So that is a strength and also sometimes a weakness. So sprint, therefore, is a framework of implementing this policy that demands that we must do CPD at school and that we must be cost effective and that we must respond to the needs of the teachers. Are we together? Are you following?
Yes.
And it's nice that you didn't eat, because I'm not singing on dozing. But for those of you who have eaten, please forgive us. Yeah, even in every shield. So now let us look at it just briefly and we move on before I lose my minutes. So if you look at this acronym SPRINT, it explains everything about its implementation and management. The acronym itself stands for Co-Program of In-Service for the Tech. Let us say it. What is it?
Co-Program of In-Service for the
Tech. Yes, Co-Program of In-Service for the Tech. That's SPRINT. So what does it mean exactly what it's saying? Our colleagues in the sports field, do they make a sports program for the year? Do they make one? Sorry? Or fixtures, eh? But they also make a program for the team. Why they will say, in this week we shall be having inter-schools, inter-zones, inter-districts. Do we have such programs in the zones or schools?
Yes.
So on the similar principle, that's how this one is. So by policy, there is a demand that every school must generate a program for training the teachers, CPD program for that particular term. So when you go to Machiko Primary School, you enter my office as the head, and ask me, sir, could you show us the program of in-service for your teachers in this school? He must show you if SPRINT is working. How many are coming from schools where such a program is existing for this particular term? Very good. And how many are here who are coming from a school where they even show such a thing happening in the ministry? Of course, it's the opposite of the few hunters, isn't it? But you feel courageous as a trainer to say it doesn't exist. If you acknowledge it exists, when it doesn't, then you don't go anywhere. But you can, even tomorrow, for example, let us just come, pass through these schools. Just go say, sir, I've come to ask you for a program for incentives for this year at this school. I can invest my 2 days and 9 hours if you are going to find half of the schools with a program. It doesn't exist. What exists is a program for the team, for sports or for something else or something else. Do you think it's a bad idea that the school must be producing this program every term? Do you think it's a bad idea? Yeah, it's a good idea. Children won't pass until you can see there that where you fail, shall children fail. Where we did better, children do better. So if I were ahead myself, I would put a lot of investment in making you better. Then my children are directly to benefit. And the issue of genetics, which he talked about, is very true. You pass, you do well, children do well. So that's where we should put our money. So the implementation part of this sprint starts with the head. By the way, it's a policy issue, and therefore the head is responsible for all policy matters in your school. If it's not happening, it's not the sick, it's not the sick, it's the head. But we'll not say much about that, since the heads are also coming for the training. Then we shall speak their language. That's fine. So, what is this hymn here? Hymn, eh? We're talking about implementation of SPRINT. The hymn there, I've got time, I'll explain fast. That is the meeting which the headmaster holds, isn't it? For the teachers. Every beginning of a term. How many had one at the hymn? And the hymn is different from a staff meeting. I'm not asking about the staff meeting. A hymn is held on a separate day from the staff meeting. It's shown in the cabinet and a small announcement with the staff meeting. Now we shall have CPD. How many are the shepherds you meeting at the school? You see? Some people are talking about that staff meeting. I've done well to clarify that part. You clap for me for clarifying. But most of you are talking about staff meeting. So the head who hold the meeting like this, me, I'm the head, he said, now today is the day for him. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Good morning. Welcome to this meeting. The agenda for him is only CPT, nothing else. So group leaders from teacher groups, they will start giving reports of what happened last term, what they want to do this term. So that report from different group leaders is what is summarized on a form to be called the school program for the term. Are we together? So people now will follow that program and start implementing it in the teacher groups in the term. It's a meeting based on that program which was agreed. And they will be monitoring to ensure that things are happening as planned on the program. And they will also be working in the holiday, teachers go in the holiday, either at a stakeholders workshop or some whichever venue which is agreed, to go and discuss matters of their professional development. Now here there is grace stroke smack. Grace is for what? Great teachers, isn't it? Yes, we may take the holiday and so take away the venue to discuss their issues. And it's normally associated with primary schools. And then we have the smart one, which is the subject meeting. That is for teachers who are at secondary school, because them there, we can know them by subject. But maybe with the coming of in specialization, we can also be part of the smart, eh? So that you have a subject to associate yourself with. So teachers in the holiday, by policy also, we are supposed to continue learning and bring our CPTs. Then we have other CPTs of a miscellaneous nature. This is miscellaneous in-service activities, which are not on the program, they are not programmed. You don't know them, but they will come at the term open. Like this one here. Did you have it on the program for the school? How many has this meeting on your school program for the term? Yeah, if you I see one, I will accuse you of witchcraft. Because you didn't know about this one, just comes up. So this one becomes miscellaneous. So that everything you do in these components of sprint, you now record them in a book we call the sub-book, isn't it? Do we have the sub-book in our school?
Yes.
And the sub-book is not completed. We have been to schools where I find the sub-book. The last entry was in 2009. The sub-book is there, but the entries are completely behind. So now this is the implementation. In terms of management of sprint, three key people must work at full throttle to make it alive. The first person is the head teacher, isn't it? Because he is the owner of school and the one who responds to policy and is the steward of all policy issues in the school. So his role is to ensure that he's providing the overall supervision of his teachers, that they are implementing the school program of in-service for the term as designed. That is giving support. That is also enforcing participation. He must be able to see, call you, why not participating? That meeting, I have not seen you in being recorded as president, ever absent. That's the role of the head in sprint. And then you have the deputy head. His role is technical. If you see the college is a vice principal, the job is to ensure that what is happening in the teacher group is qualitative, because it's a professional. You're not just meeting to meet for the sake of meeting, but you are doing quality activities in your teacher groups. And that which you are doing in the teacher groups is contributing to your good teaching. And so you must ensure that it is contributing to classroom practice. You are planning and you are not improving. You are going to do activities, you are not improving in the school, in the chapel. The deputy head must watch on you. He must ensure also adherence that the plan, every group is meeting as planned. Then we have the coordinator, the famous coordinator. Either the school is service coordinator at the school level or the CPD coordinator for secondary schools, terminology or college. The role of this one is very simple. Communication. Trying to identify the needs. Trying to arrange all these aspects required to do to implement CPD. And communicating upwards and downwards. Management to the teachers across. Oh, that's the job of coordination. And monitoring. But all these three, they do the monitoring. So when these three are operating properly, effectively, all of them, then the spirit in that school is strong. If one of them is not minding, forget. What you find is what you are seeing in the school. And all these are done at zero cost, by the way. Or very minimum cost in the school. So why is it so strong? But then we blame the spirit and you leave out those people who are supposed to make it strong. And you even find the head saying, oh, spirit doesn't do it. And that is the indicator. In one school in Central Province with this, you're asking the head, sir, you have the hymn. The hymn. Oh, let me call the deputy. And the deputy is, the deputy also comes. Sir, I've called the soul. Did we have the hymn in the school? Can you find me the file for him? You see, now that's where the problem is. And we're not alone. Thank you very much for this ends my presentation on spirit. So what's lesson study? Lesson study is a learning of among us a team. Peer to peer. Learning from one another. Enhancing the capacities of each other to improve learning. Using a certain process that we shall go through now. So as you observe, you are demonstrating, you are planning together, you demonstrate, and you also assess those lessons together. See the weaknesses and agree on the strengths and what should be done. And once we improve, then you begin to implement it as such. When a lesson study is effective, you go in a school, you are going to find a number of lesson plans which were done on different topics by those teachers. So a new teacher, when he comes going to teach on equations and equations, you simply get a file and check through the lesson plan that was done, that was discussed and so on, and you learn quickly. Anyhow, so the purpose of lesson study is for the learning of teachers. And we are saying not in pupils, not for pupils. People who are learning in lesson study are teachers. Pupils are not even aware that you are doing lesson study. Okay? They are not even aware there is no more lesson. And they are learning their puberty lesson. And yet you are learning the use of teaching material on the lesson of puberty. So it's for you, it's for me, the teacher. So when you go in the materials you'll be given, everything is about your learning in order to make others learn. I'm going to mention that one. So it improves teaching. So, I'm going to explain that one. So the steps of lesson study are 8, and I'll try to slow down a bit here so that we get them correct. It's a process. It's actually 2 steps, 2 cycles, but counted as one. Because you repeat the first 4. The first step you have is to define what is it that you want to do. So these are the eight steps. So step number one there, or first, the first one I've said, and then it repeats to up to the eighth step. But you need to define, what are we doing here? It is, we are meeting as a teacher group. What are we meeting for today? Today we want to learn and find out how to make learners add or understand addition of decimals. What could be the problem with addition of decimals on the learners? Maybe they don't know how to find the point, they don't know how, they don't understand what a decimal is or what can we discuss in depth. After discussing, then you start going through the materials on the topic decimals. And thereafter, you together plan the lesson. Take into account all the things we have discussed. Together you plan. And the lesson you are planning is for the group. It's not for any individual. Whether that teacher has been there for 1 year, 10 years, 15 years, 30 years in the school, you plan together, level the fields to make this thing accessible by everyone. And then you go to try it in class. If you want, you can still try it before you go to class, but it must be taken to class. That's where you are going to find the actual aspect or quality of the lesson that you have planned. After demonstrating, what should come next? You do what? Yes, you ask yourself, what have we achieved? You reflect, what happened? And then when you are doing this, that's why this step repeats. You are actually already defining the problem. If you're here, these are the answers. So after doing that, then you revise the lesson, taking into account the issues that you have discussed for improvement. And then you take it to class again. Now this time to different learners, not the same learners. If you only have one class, then you are also going to divide the class like this. The first class will take this, the second half of the class will take the other one. You are following, eh? Yes. Then after implementing the revised lesson, what next again? Yeah? Again, reflect. Where have the improvements been made? Ah, yes, the life was good now. Good, good, good. After that, then you say, now let us now compile what we have learned and share with other teachers in the school, in the zone, in the district, how addition of decimals can be well taught, because you have researched on it, you have tried it, and it has worked. You can even compile with a school magazine or a small report. Then share it with others. If it didn't improve here, please go through again. You can even go through a number of times that you don't want. But it must improve. So if you don't do a good job on reflecting on the lesson, you'll discover that your lesson will either be the same even when you go here, or it may even be poorer if you don't reflect very nicely on that part. So let me see if I have all the notes for you. On this slide you'll be given, so you can pay attention. I've already explained this. But what is the key when you are planning?
Is what I want to say.
To repeat this. These are basically what takes place in the teacher group. All this, by the way, will be taking place in the teacher group. What is key here to have a quality lesson study? Like I said, create a level field. Let everyone feel free to participate. Let no one be the source of knowledge all the time. The one to demonstrate pays even much more if the one who is weak in this area is the one who demonstrates. It is also good if the one who knows it well does so. But both ways works very well. Because it's about capacity building. So if a person who doesn't know very well is one who teaches, and you criticize the lesson and you help him improve, next time the confidence increases when he succeeds, and the knowledge and also increases. So by that way, it works as a tool for CPD. No rankism, please, in your TGMs. The rankism is the aspect of considering one's rank and status. It's a big barrier to learning, to yourself. And in our spirit manuals, we have spoken so much against this aspect of rankism. So, even this week, tomorrow, you'll be in groups, and you'll be people with different ranks. That rank won't enter into a group. All of us are professionals when we are teaching that group. So while a PRC soup in your group is a teacher, and you would not say, no, PRC, that's... So you will come as a teacher and participate in what you can even argue with. Doesn't matter whether it's whoever comes there, the rank won't enter in the circle. Now at school, some will say, me, I am a degree holder. What should I be doing with the certificate holder? You can see how that becomes a barrier to himself to learn. And it's becoming a serious barrier to our learning, especially the qualification. And yet we have seen so many people getting degrees and therefore so many children failing as well. And the teachers get 5 fails in the test the same way the others have failed the test. The child, they get 5 child has only been in school for 4 years, isn't it? You have gone to get 7, get 9, get 12, college, come to get 5 and you fail with the one who has just joined you. Oh my God. Sad story. So, but learning still continues. Even if I was given an example. So, but what's important for me to continue learning and having passion for learning? Sometimes people say, me, I've taught this, I've been here for 20 years. I don't need a book, I just go to class without a book. So what can I do with these new ones? And by the way, even this rankism I'm hearing, that us are from public colleges, we are better. These are from private, we don't need this, where are they coming from? That's just some form of rankism, I think it's bad. You will not learn very well together with such teachers when you're in the school. I appreciate everyone who the government has said. And this program will help capacity build yourself and capacity build those people have a gap. It doesn't become so judgmental about our friends and colleagues. It's very professional. So the third phase I've already mentioned here, I want to go to this phase of reflecting about the lesson. Sorry, I'm jumping because time is running out for me. It takes 1 month to train people in lesson study, minimum. So we understand. But as we could stay together here up to the fourth day, I think we will master it. Okay, these are just theories and information. Reflecting, as I said, if you don't reflect very well on your lesson which was conducted, you will not improve it very well. Because you haven't seen the problem. You haven't seen. You haven't diagnosed the problem very well. So, as the most crucial step, please always start by giving the one who demonstrated first chance to speak. He's the one who was in the water. No one can tell you how deep the water was or how cold or hot the water was. Not you was just looking. So let him speak, let us speak of what happened in the lesson, how it speaks of the learners. And then thereafter others can do it. And since it's a teacher group, it's collaborative, it's owned by everyone. So don't say, you teacher, you did this. Why did you write 5 here? We said you write 6. And you were on the point facing one direction. That girl there suffered in the corner. What were you looking at that side? That guy will never demonstrate again. You have effectively eliminated him from your group. So be courteous and have respect for the teacher who demonstrated. In fact, you must really thank him. And then speak about the lesson. And whatever mistake on it, I think there we didn't do well. We, always we, not you. We. Maybe we should have used this one. Maybe we should have done like this. I think next time, let's do like this. So it's going collaboratively. You are owning all the positives and negatives as a group. Now, here I was saying, apply critical lenses to the lesson. I think I've already mentioned the seriousness of what it means to reflect on the lesson. Don't just deflect, don't just see the observable. Where even, like I always say, where even my grandmother can observe and criticize this in the same fashion as me. Me, I should do more. I should see more things than any other person. Now, if you come and say, the voice was not clear, man. Anybody can hear that you were flat, isn't it? These are the obvious. Your dressing, you should have packed in the sheets. Where was it outside? Anybody can see against that. And if I tapped in, the rest of them will change. Let's look at that which improves teaching and learning, the actual content and for the children to learn. And that's why we advise, reflect from the learning point, not from the teaching point. Yes, please. Wow, thank you. From the learning point, they will talk about learners. Hello, teacher. Last year in May and June, we are conducting training at Science Center for KCCPM. Maybe some of you came. And we said, let us analyze the instruments that they use in the colleges and in their countries. We had 17 countries that came. And we just did. You look at an IPM which is assessing the teacher, and an IPM which is assessing the learner. It was all teacher. 90% my teacher did this. Teacher. So if you go there, you feel this to help the teacher. So you will say, are we really assessing learning or assessing teaching? One time teaching or managing. They were amazed themselves. So when you go yourself, please focus on teaching, on the learning. But what we are saying is, let us plan as well as doing a little study. Plan with an objective. You must identify something you want to do. And therefore, when you are observing the lesson, you focus on something, what you plan to see and to study. It's lesson study. So what are you studying when you are sitting down? So focus on that. So observe with focus. And as I said, you reflect with openness. And courteous and respect. Don't become critical for nothing, and then you begin attacking. Everything is about you.